Welcome back to Health Haven Tips, your trusted source for all things health and wellness. Today, we're diving deep into a topic that's making waves in the world of nutrition, lab-grown meat. Is it the future of food or a risky experiment? Stay tuned to uncover the truth. Lab-grown meat, also known as cultivated or cell-based meat, is no longer science fiction. It's here, it's real, and it's being approved for sale by none other than the USDA and even Singapore. But what's the story behind this innovation and why should you care? First things first, what led to the approval of lab-grown meat by the USDA? We'll uncover this and discuss the implications. In recent years, media reports have warned about the world's increasing population and the limited land available for food production. Are we on the brink of a global food crisis? Or are these fear tactics? And let's not forget the environment. Cows, often blamed for climate change, have come under scrutiny. But is this a fair judgment? Have we explored alternative solutions like regenerative agriculture? Not yet, but there's another player in this field, lab-grown meat. It's not science fiction, it's real, and it's called Good Meat, produced by a company called Eat Just Inc. Their website boasts that they are the first company to sell cultivated meat. It's all about making sustainable, safe meat from animal cells without slaughtering animals. But let's break down the words they use. Slaughtered animals and safe. Who determines this? Where's their research? What about long-term studies on human safety? In reality, it's all marketing. Claims of being safe, environmentally friendly, and sustainable are abundant. But how do they back up these claims? One thing they undoubtedly have is significant financial backing. With hundreds of millions of dollars supporting them, the marketing messages will flood your screens. But what if I told you it's a gamble? This Frankenstein meat might not be the best option. Let's talk about the backing behind Good Meat. Initial funding of $200 million and another $97 million raised in 2021. The money mainly comes from venture capital firms in the United States and Singapore. This VC model thrives on high-risk, high-reward investments. Many companies might fail, but the VCs still rake in profits, so they push those failed companies hard, pouring in hundreds of millions to make them successful. The result? Hefty marketing campaigns will make you believe in all those positive benefits, and fear and anger tactics won't be spared. But remember, they have no long-term human safety studies. None. Not even short-term studies. So, are you ready to be the guinea pig in this experiment? I won't be, and I urge you to think twice too. Now let's delve into a sustainable alternative, regenerative agriculture. While it's often overlooked, it offers a powerful solution to our pressing environmental concerns. In recent years, regenerative agriculture has gained recognition as a transformative approach to farming that not only ensures food production but also revitalizes our ecosystems. Unlike conventional agriculture, which may deplete the soil and contribute to environmental degradation, regenerative agriculture seeks to restore the land. Regenerative agriculture is all about working with nature, not against it. It promotes practices like crop rotation, cover cropping, and minimal tillage, which not only improves soil health but also sequester carbon back into the ground. Conventional agriculture often relies on heavy chemical inputs, which can lead to soil erosion and contamination. In contrast, regenerative methods embrace biodiversity, encouraging the growth of various crops and native species. This shift towards regenerative agriculture helps mitigate climate change by absorbing excess carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and nurturing our land to thrive. By emphasizing regenerative agriculture, we can reduce our carbon footprint and foster healthier ecosystems. It's a key step towards a sustainable future. But here's where you come in. We want to hear from you, our fantastic Health Haven Tips community. In the comment section below, suggest topics you'd like us to cover in future videos. If you choose to eat meat, choose real meat. Avoid lab-grown, cultivated meat. Opt for organic or pastured meat whenever possible. As we wrap up our journey today, I want to leave you with this. The choices we make regarding our food can significantly impact our world. Whether it's embracing lab-grown meat or supporting regenerative agriculture, the power lies in your hands. Choose wisely. If you found this information eye-opening, make sure to hit the like button, share this video with your fellow truth seekers, and don't forget to subscribe to Health Haven Tips for more enlightening content. Thank you for joining us today at Health Haven Tips. Until next time, stay curious, stay informed, and stay healthy. This is Health Haven Tips signing off.